Hi guys, welcome to the unboxing and quick review of these V2 TWS earbuds. They are some kind of Apple style, means AirPod style. They have about same shape and same size. And yeah, we get this box here. By the way, I've seen them on a listing on Amazon for about $40 or $50, so I think they are in a good medium price, not too high like the AirPods original for $160, and also not too cheap. I mean, you can buy similar stuff on wish.com for $5. And then they fall apart after a couple of hours, so it's always good to have something decent in between. Yeah, here we have some of the details. I think the specs are about on a similar level as the AirPods. So we get a couple of hours of sound and talking, and we can charge them a couple of times here on this cradle. Let's see what we else get in this box here. Here we get this cable, really short lightning cable, which is good for charging. And here we get some instructions and also an invitation to leave a review on Amazon, and then after reviewing you can confirm and you will get this nice free Bluetooth speaker. I haven't tried that, but I guess it should work. So let's go to the instructions. So here we are. I'm going to show that to you very quickly so you get all the details if you like them. If you don't need that, you can skip that, of course. If you want to read that, just go to the highest resolution, 1080p, and you should be able to read that. Of course, that was the beginning here, where you see all the buttons, all the functions, how to pair everything, how to charge. Yeah, that's easy in the box, and we have these touch functions, and then after that, that's the second page. So pretty easy, straightforward, not too much. Here we get this nice box. They are charged when they are, as long as they are in the box. When you open them, they go into pairing mode, and you can go to your phone and Bluetooth settings and search for V2 and then click on connect, and it's no problem. I've been doing that, and it worked pretty easy, straightforward, no problem with that. So you really have to just open that and they go into pairing mode. What they do first, they go into pairing mode with each other, so they connect to each other, and after that they will connect to your phone or to your PC, wherever you want to connect them. So give them just a little bit of time, because they have to do this double pairing process, which takes a little bit more time. Here we have these nice earbuds, and as you can see, they are pretty much same style, same shape as the Apple AirPods have. They are here a little bit thicker, I think. When we look at them from this side, they are pretty much the same as the AirPods. Here they are a little bit thicker, but apart from that, I think the earpieces are pretty much the same. That means actually we don't get any soft rubber here, and that means of course less passive noise canceling. So that's this design, it comes from Apple. So we cannot change that. So it has also some advantages. With less passive noise canceling, you will be able to talk easier to other people. Let's say if you wear them in the office, it shouldn't be a problem if people are talking to you. If you wear them in the gym, no problem with that. To talk to other people, you will hear everything. If you go on a bike ride, you will still hear the traffic. That's the good thing. On the negative side, of course, It won't have this ultra deep bass sound, which you can have with these soft rubber earpieces, of course, but you have the choice. So the good thing is really I had them in my ears for a couple of hours and they felt pretty comfortable and they didn't fall out, so surprisingly stable. So this is my first pair with this style, and yeah, I felt really comfortable. I think I could really wear them the whole day, no problem with that. By the way, here we have the charging pins. You have to make sure to keep them clean so they can charge. There's also this LED. I think it's only built in on into one of the earbuds where you can see when it is connecting. By the way, they come with a touch sensitive area here. That's the only like button here, and this is multifunction. Like one touch is start, stop, play, take call, a call or drop a call. Then you have the double touch, which is going to the next or previous track, and then you have a long press where you can activate Google Helper or Google Assistant or Siri. That's it, and it is on both sides, and you cannot change the volume on the earpieces. For to change the volume, you have to go to your mobile phone or PC. And the most important things like connecting, disconnecting, pairing and so on, you will get an announcement through the speaker. The announcements are a little bit loud, but you can definitely hear them very clearly. The microphone, I think we have here in the back. Here these two openings, I guess, are the microphones, and the microphone works pretty good so far. I would say on a good average, definitely on this price range. I've been testing and recording some sound, and I'm going to play that now for you so you can listen to that.
TWS Audio Test V2, TWS Audio Test.
So for me, that is definitely on a decent level, so you can make phone calls and record easy stuff. But of course, it's not a professional microphone, but I would say definitely on a good level. Yeah, the power consumption seems to be pretty low. Charging has been quite easy and fast, a little bit slower as indicated in the instructions. Instead of 1 amp, I got only 0.4 amps, so it took me about 2 hours instead of 1 hour, but I don't mind. I usually charge these things overnight, so it doesn't bother me. So the build quality looks really good, and yeah, I have already dropped the left one from about 3 feet to a tile floor, and I couldn't see any damage at all, and it works absolutely the same as before, no problem with that. So looks, it's pretty, yeah, they are pretty sturdy. After about 1 hour of lot of usage, or even a little bit longer, the power was still showing 100%, so looks like they last quite long. Yeah, again, pairing was pretty easy, at least on my phone. Not so much on my PC, but I think the problem is the Bluetooth adapter on my PC. And yeah, so every time when I reconnected, the volume was on 100%, which is a little bit crazy loud, and other problems. But I have been able to switch back and forth from PC to mobile phone after a couple of trials. Once it had only been connected to one of the earpieces, then I switched back to the mobile phone and back to the PC, and yeah, it worked again. There is described that there should be a reset. I haven't found that. It's not in the instructions. I have nothing found about a reset button or something like that. So it looks like it's just not here, but every time you have a problem, put it back in the cradle. It's, by the way, it's pretty easy. I think here we have the left one. If you look at them and see the L charging LEDs, and here you have the right ones. I haven't seen any indicator on the earbuds, but the good thing, yeah, you can close them and it will charge right away. If you want to stop that, you can double click and it stops. If you want to start that, you can just click once. By the way, this is also, I think, not described in the instructions, but it seems to work pretty good. Here, the lightning adapter to charge. I think it's a pretty solid device. Of course, yeah, definitely again, no soft rubber ear tips for ultra deep bass sound, but it has the advantage that it has less passive noise cancelling, so you can easy talk to other people without having to remove them out of your ears. That's also an advantage, and they are pretty comfortable. If you have these soft rubber earpieces, it can be quite uncomfortable after some time. So the connection also was pretty stable over the whole time. I haven't had any drops, and if you have them, just put them back in the cradle and reconnect, and it shouldn't be a problem. By the way, seems to be really Bluetooth 5.0 because I've been able to pair them to different devices. Of course, you cannot be connected at the same time to different devices, but you can pair them to different devices and then switch back and forth pretty easy. So it seems like it's a good thing. So I cannot really complain about that. It is this Apple design. Either you love it or you hate it. And if you love it, yeah, why not to buy these ones in for about a third of the price of the original ones. And I will put down the link to the Amazon listing down into the feedback area, and yeah, just check it out and order them right from there if you like them. And I hope I was able to help you a little bit with this video. If you have any questions or comments, just write to the comment section below. I'm always happy to talk about these things, and if you like the video, give me a thumbs up, subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.